Hi beautiful human being, here's Didi from Yoga Fitter and Stronger Forever. In this video, I'm gonna share with you 8 tips that took me about 13 years to figure out. So maybe for some people it takes less long, okay? For me it has taken all this time because I was very lazy and because I was very sick. So I want to share that with you. This is my transformation video. I hope it could help somebody out there to, let's say, go into the right direction. Please stay until the end of the video because at the end, I'm gonna give you the best tip ever to speed up your transformation process. And if you don't have time to watch the end of the video, well, you can just scroll down until the end. Before we start, so I'm going to very shortly explain to you why I think it's a really good transformation because I originally suffered from a chronic condition called lymphedema. Okay, so I'm not gonna talk to you about this. This is really not nice and I hate talking about it. But very shortly, so lymphedema is a chronic condition which affects all the body. So basically, the lymphatic system is compromised and so you have a pump in your body that helps you to kind of remove all the toxins. I don't have that. And people think it's a skin condition. It's not only a skin condition, it also affects your heart, okay? That's why you cannot pump the toxins out. So meaning you have to actually pump all the toxins yourself out. And that's why it took so many years, I think. So I have learned how to replace this deficiency in my body and I want to share that with you today. If you want to know a little bit about my, let's say, journey, you can check my previous videos about yoga. They will help you to figure out where I come from. I come from a stage where I had to wear a compressible garment on my left hand all the time, 7 days a week and 8 hours per day because you cannot wear it at night, otherwise my arm will be swollen. So this has really impacted me and I started on taking yoga classes, so yoga has tremendously helped, but also food, and that's why I'm going to talk to you about my my change, okay, my tremendous transformation, because one of the reasons why my health has changed dramatically is because of my diet. So tip number one is breakfast. So people really are taking breakfast granted, okay? They take granted on breakfast. This is the number one meal that will make a difference in your day. So I have changed my breakfast. I will make a video actually on what I eat. But just to give you an example, I used to have cereals for breakfast and now I don't have cereals anymore because they kill your energy. So stay away from cereals. Also, I have included cold showers. So it's one of my previous videos and cold bath. So it has really, really helped me to feel re-energized, to reconnect with my body and also with force, with my mind, because it's like a big change in your face and in your skin as well. So cold shower, cold bath, definitely recommended. Tip number two, it's the mind. So of course, if you don't put your mind into it, if you get up in the morning and the first thing you do is to slouch on the couch, and you just watch TV, that's gonna be really unlikely that you start working out. So this is the first things in the morning that you're gonna be doing that are gonna make a big difference for the rest of the day. So what I do myself, okay, you don't have to do this, but I'm telling you what works for me. It's to listen to some music in the shower. So get up, first thing in the morning, take a hot shower or a cold shower and put some music on. Tip number three is supplementing your diet. So of course there are loads of different types of supplements out there. I take vitamin D because the vitamin D prevents you from developing any kind of cancer or any kind of related disease. Tip number four. So people will recommend you to work out 20 minutes per day. And some people out there think that by walking in the park for 15 minutes, they have done your workout for the day. I'm really sorry, but 20 minutes per day, it's simply not enough. Okay? If you really want to see a big difference in your life and in your body and your mind, you need to work at least for 1 hour and a half. Okay? If you want to see the difference. Of course, if you're just hoping that you're just going to maintain, if you want to maintain what you have, 1 hour is enough. But if you really want to push yourself and see a transformation happening, I tell you, I work out for 4 hours per day, minimum. Okay? Three times per week, of course. This is consistency, okay? Everybody in the fitness industry talks about consistency. And for the reason, for the simple reason that consistency is a major key in all industries, okay? In fitness, in yoga, in bodybuilding, in calisthenic. So all of them, they have one thing in common, it's consistency, and we will never argue about this. Oh, drop me a comment below this video if you don't agree with that. Okay, so the tip number five, it's working out with a friend. So if you work on your own, I was finding that so boring. This is the most boring thing you can do. It's to be on your own and to work out, and you're not gonna see any change and you're not gonna see any results happening. So when you work with a buddy, you find out some weaknesses about yourself, but you find out some strengths as well. And what's amazing is that there is not much chance that the other person has the same weakness and the same strengths. So you can work together and you can really be a team. And this is fantastic. And I'm so glad I have different fitness buddies that I can work with, because working out sometimes can be really dubious. So the tip number six is progress. So you need to monitor your progress, because if you don't do it, you will get discouraged, and that will probably jeopardize your chances to grow. Okay, so I give you an example of my own progress. So in August, I was doing headstand. I was doing headstand against the wall, and I had no clue. I was like, I'm never gonna be able to do anything than headstand. I was really discouraged. I was wondering why I was not progressing. And when I started to monitor every day my progress, things have tremendously changed. I managed to do handstand without the wall, and then after I actually started to do handstand and handstand balance. And so this is a general balance in the body that you will obtain, and it starts with monitoring your progress. So you can maybe buy a little journal and journaling every day what you've done and how much progress you have accomplished. Okay, the tip number seven is recovery. So recovery, we don't talk about it very much. So me, I'm gonna give you one tip that works great for me. It's trampoline. You see, we can see it in the background. So trampoline is one of the best way to rebalance your body and your mind when you're tired. So if you do like a kind of a cardio workout and a handstand, a balance, okay, and you the next day you might be feeling a little bit exhausted, well, buy a trampoline, and I'll tell you that's gonna really, really make a big difference. Okay, so we are tip number, I'm so disorganized. Tip number 7, tip number 8. Tip number 8 is a general one, but believe it or not, people have some trouble to follow that one. So that's why I have included it in my video one more time. This is one of the hardest things on earth to do. It's to be kind with yourself. To be kind with yourself and to accept your progress of the day and not to, let's say, not to burn the steps. So one step at a time, baby steps, and you will get there eventually. Okay, that's it, guys. So please comment, drop me a comment below this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, and let me know which tips worked the best for you for more free fitness tips and yoga tips. I wish you a good day. Take care of yourself. Namaste.